In this movie, I will demonstrate how you can assess the quality of the imported next-generation sequencing runs. Once the data is imported in the BioNumerics database, one can have a detailed look at the data in the Sequence Reset experiment card. The experiment card can be opened by clicking the experiment dot. From the Sequence Reset report, some basic summary statistics on the reads present in the dataset are displayed, including information on readset size, sequence length statistics, quality statistics, and individual base statistics. For this dataset, we can see that over 6 million of single-end reads were imported, all having a read length of 90 base pairs. The average base quality was calculated as 36.24, and base qualities vary between 4 and 40. From the base statistics, we can learn how many A, C, T, and Gs were counted, and how many other bases or ends were detected in the sequencing reads. As for the last statistic, the number of bases GC is indicated, being 49.54 in this case. From these preliminary statistics, and knowing that this sample was derived from E. coli, we can already be confident on the run quality, as the GC content of E. coli is known to vary around 50.5. On a more detailed level, it is very interesting to consult the predefined charts by clicking the second button. Here you can learn more about the average read quality distribution, the base distribution, the read length distribution, etc. Any of the dedicated charts will automatically be created based upon the read information present in the sequence read set at hand. As an example, we can select the existing chart template to plot the average read quality distribution and press OK. This launches the Charts and Statistics window, where the quality distribution is plotted. From this figure, we can easily see that the bulk of the reads has an average read quality of about 36.2. We can close this chart and try another template. We can now select the read set base distribution plot. Except from some distortions in the first 10 base pairs of the reads, we can observe an even distribution over the bases A, C, T, and G. From this chart, it is very straightforward to detect whether or not the primer sequences were cut during import. As a third chart, we can have a look at the average quality distribution. One can clearly see a decline in average base quality from a quality score of 38 to 33 along the reads. As a last example, we can create a chart for the quality distribution by percentage GC. From this graph, we can see the read quality distribution over the percent GC range. This graph shows us that for this dataset, the low percentage GC reads are generally of higher quality than the reads having a high GC content. As can be seen from these examples, the chart templates may provide insight in the sequence run quality and the possible presence of sequence artifacts in the run in a quick and easy way. From these preliminary insights, assessments can be made for the required pre-processing steps before starting the actual analysis. The next video will demonstrate how to pre-process these sequence runs.